Hey everyone, it's Mark Sargent, and this is Flat Earth Q&A emails number 16. Everybody knows the drill by now. You send me emails to msargent23@comcast.net, and if they're interesting, I will read them either on Strange World or I will read them here in a separate email show. So let's get right to it. First email is from Sean. It's titled, "What Did You Do to My Mind? Once I realized flat earth, oh, enclosed earth, winky face, I see conspiracies everywhere that I never noticed before. The mountains could be the stumps of giant trees. Jackie killed JFK. False flags. I think it's crazy that this is now my reality, but I love it. Keep fighting the good fight. Sean Hartwell." And again, flat earth will open your mind to a whole bunch of different things. The mountains could be the stumps of giant trees. Wonderful. Also known as there are no forests on flat earth. Jackie killing JFK. I don't know about that. She was trying to crawl off the back of that car. I honestly think it was the one of the Secret Service drivers that did it. But yeah, flat earth opens your mind to a whole bunch of new concepts. Next email is from Jason. Jason writes, "Hey Mark, I was watching an old episode of Star Trek The Next Generation, Season 6, Episode 19, called Lessons, when I noticed something very interesting in the first couple minutes. Picard walks into stellar cartography, which, as you know, means mapping the stars, and there is a device they are all standing around that looks pretty darn familiar. You should check it out. Netflix should have it. Peace, man. Jason." Yeah. I absolutely will check it out. I haven't seen it yet, but who knows. Also, if anyone texts me to 303-494-6631, note that I will not respond to your text, but if it's long enough, and again, interesting enough, I will read it, even though I hate staring at my tiny little phone. So let's give it a shot, shall we? Mark, this is from Jay Bean. "I thought I would try texting first since it's more direct, but I watched your video, Hiding God Everywhere, and I am experiencing a whirlwind of emotions and have many questions. If you don't have time to respond now, I understand, so I will try my second favorite method of communication, writing. My name is Jessica Sims. Expect a letter soon. Smiley face, J. Bean." Jessica Sims, but anyway. So thank you very much for that. Let's get rid of that one. And let's try this one. I gotta scroll all the way to the top on this. Sorry, it's kind of a long text. Wow, he typed a lot of stuff. "Your theory makes sense, but first you need to get out of the learned two-dimensional realm and visualize it on a three-dimensional platform. Then it makes perfect sense. Kind of a reverse psychology type of scenario. Confuse the mind and the learned preconceived notions will allow you to follow the set path of what they, the government, tell you that you should believe. Quite ingenious, if you ask me. They turn your very own intuitiveness against you in order to make it easy for you to believe the lie that they want you to believe. You see, the only reason, I mean only reason, that the Earth has a curvature when viewed or filmed at a high altitude is because the higher you approach the ceiling, the more light waves are bent, therefore making the curve, which, like bending light waves with a crystal held in your hand against the sun and slightly moving the crystal around and seeing the different changes in color as well as pattern. So basically, the curvature of the Earth is caused by what I like to call the dome effect. You can call me if you choose and we can talk further on the subject. If not, that's okay as well. Have a good day. And may I also add this, why do they call it a prison planet? It works out nice to push the sheeple into the corner of the perceived oppression of the government. That way, there is no need for explanation, right? Everything works out according to the specified agenda. You can always lead a horse. We are in a prison planet. We were put, sentenced here for our crimes and or indiscretions from a past life, like microbes in a petri dish, if you will. We are studied according to our past and present behaviors and the preconceived notions of what is the so-called normal behavior according to a higher power, whether it be God or whatever. It's all a test. Some get it, some don't. If we do good, we might be able to leave when we die. If not, we return and try to get it right based on our individual circumstances from our past. It's all pretty simple, if you ask me. Common sense, really. The whole reason the Columbus accidentally landed in America was because of navigational error. He followed the stars, which on a flat earth would give him a straight line of direction to America and not to India. When that curvature is taken out of the equation, so how did they even know of a curved plane of travel back then? You might need to ask the ancient Egyptians how they built the pyramids. That is all. Thanks. That's awesome. And last text, long text message that I get. This one's from Brad. Hello, I'm a flat earther. I'll try to get the truth out there. And I got a question and I really need your help with. How do we explain the night and day phenomenon over Alaska? You have 6 months daylight and 6 months night. Please reply. Thank you so much for your videos and keep in touch. My name is Brad, by the way. So that's the end of those text messages. And I'm sorry, some of those are pretty old, but that's because when I spend time in Canada, I'm down in the States right now. But when I spend time in Canada, I forward all my, I just turn off the phone. I, you know, do a *72 thing and forward all my phone calls to my Skype account. And then when it comes to texts, I don't forward them at all. They just stay here in my phone until I open it up. Sometimes it could be days. Sometimes it could be weeks. Really plans or depends when I get back to the States. So thank you for that. But yes, if you're going to contact me, please email me first. msargent23@comcast.net. Or call. You can either call 303-494-6631 or 720-897-6111, which is the show number. So let's pan back over to the emails. Let's get right back into it. All right. This one's from... Who's this from? No idea. It's from TBMC. Mark, don't read my real email address. All right, I won't. Hi, I'm Timothy. I'm a professional hockey player and have military experience. I'm a hunter and am a trained Aboriginal naturalist. I'd like one of your survival guides if you don't mind. Okay, cool. I've been awake since 2004 of the NWO agenda and the deep level of manipulation going on, and never could have dreamed Flat Earth was a reality. It is incredible. I recognize the moon hoax. I've seen the Masonic flags and the Masons involvement in world affairs. I've seen 9/11 truth every day. I'm sorry, very early. It really was a shock when it all came together with Flat Earth evidence finally overtaking the deepest programming yet. I was also a huge fan of Joe Rogan and the outer space Carl Sagan model. But in September of 2015, I sold a truck to a Christian guy who told me about the sun rays and that the earth was flat. The first time I ever heard such a thing, it was like a shock therapy meeting someone so sure, and also a time bomb. It stayed in my mind and didn't overcome the ball hypnosis till about 7 months later when I found videos pop up on YouTube. At that same time, I heard Joe Rogan laugh for the third show in a row of getting emails to look at Eric Dubay and Flat Earth. So I watched 200 Proofs. By number 23, it came together in my mind, all the years, all the level of water and flatness, all the Masonic symbols, all the NASA lies. It was kind of beautiful and painful at the same time. I walked around in a daze for weeks after. I imagine this happened to a lot of people. It happened to me. It is truly the ultimate open mind test and ultimate truth. I hope you and Eric mend fences and become allies against Joe Rogan. Me too. It would be amazing to see you and Eric debate Joe Rogan and Brian Colin? C-A-L-L-E-N? Isn't it Colin or Cullen? It doesn't matter. It would be a complete ball earth logic sacrifice for the whole world to see. I love music. Hendrix had a song called Earth Blues he played live. When he played it with Johnny Winter on recording, he says, on this flat earth. Do you think Nirvana's On a Plane means anything? Interesting. Or Beatles' Fool on the Hill has eyes in his head that see the world spinning round, but he's a fool, right? Bob Marley. Preacher Man will tell you heaven is under the earth, but he doesn't know what life is really worth. Just reevaluating a lot of songs, still searching. Big fan of yours. You really made it easy to understand the truth. Love your weekly shows and the work you've done. Thanks, Mark. Awesome, man. Thank you for that. David writes, Mark, first wish to thank you for making the Matrix a living reality, but one I trust was a more benevolent master than robots. I've been listening to both you and Rob Skiba. I've felt that there is a bigger truth out there, bigger than what most folks want. Bigger than what even religious folks want. So crazy big. So thank you for helping me bringing so many pieces together. Remember, if you're going to use spell check, read it afterwards, because sometimes the words are not what you think they are. On a table so I could see that they do fit together. So many things that just don't fit neatly into group's narrative, but kept poking me till I could put the pieces together. Now I'm afraid that I've scaled Mount Everest. Now there may be something even bigger. Thanks again. Now for something that's been poking me ever since I reviewed your chapter on the GPS for flights in the Southern Hemisphere. If they are actually flying north, so they don't have to fly the long way around, but they turn off the GPS so it doesn't leave a trail of a path that only makes sense on a flat Earth, what do you see as implications of the airliners lost in the Indian Ocean? Shouldn't the GPS shown their last area at least an approximation? Yeah, you're absolutely right. Except that when they go into the Indian Ocean, if it goes into approximated or estimated mode, why did they have a hard time even finding a search area? I don't know. I don't think that they actually knew where it was, unless they were on a path that makes no sense in a globe, which they absolutely would have to cover up to conceal the existence of a path that would only make sense on a flat Earth. Thus, showing more evidence and reinforcing the growing evidence of a flat Earth, they must have had a hell of a time squelching those stories in the mainstream media, but then again, maybe not. Is there a probable path that these airliners should have taken based on a flat Earth flight? Perhaps, if it could be found, it would expose the truth publicly. Best regards, David. Thanks, David, and I think you're right. Do I think it's going to be that, you know, that the whole Malaysian airline thing, is that going to be the silver bullet? No, probably not. So let's go to Marty. Marty writes, I was listening to your Q&A and heard you talking about the 223 rifle. And being a hunter and long-range shooter myself, I agree with the purpose of the 223 as far as wounding the enemy. By the way, the 223 is also the 5.56 military. I know there's a slight pressure difference. If you guys want to know what the difference between a 223 and a 5.56, when I understand it's like a 5% pressure increase for the military version. You're thinking, well, that's not a lot. Well, it isn't until you do, you know, unless the weapon doesn't have enough tolerance for that. And then repetitive increased pressure is going to wear the weapon down a lot quicker. The rules of war at the time dictated full metal jacket projectiles. And when you use a 55 grain full metal jacket from a 223, they tend to just punch a pencil size hole through flesh and bone, not doing a whole lot of damage. So the ballistics experts, knowing that the rifling required to stabilize a 55 green bullet would not stabilize a longer, heavier bullet, experimented with heavier projectiles in the 69 to 77 grain class and found accuracy was not good at all and caused the bullet to tumble through the air instead of flying straight and true, like a pass from Tim Tebow. Nice Tim Tebow reference. Gotta have that in there. And that a bullet hitting the target sideways, wobbling and flip-flopping through the flesh and bone of the enemy did a lot more damage than a straight tiny hole. Never mind that they were not accurate. Because they were firing from three-shot bursts in full auto weapons, it was the volume of multiple projectiles going down range that did the damage instead of the accurate, precise shots. So that was their way around the tiny bullet flying straight and true and not doing much damage. And the whole thing with downsizing from the 30-06 to the 308 and then on down to the 223 was the fact that given the amount of weight, the guy packing a 308 rifle could carry more shells. Yes, I know all this. I've read all this stuff. Than a man with a 30-06. You got to love the old name 30-ought, double-ought. It's great stuff. And the guy with a 223, even more ammo could be carried with a certain amount of space and weight. That all being said, listeners should know that a 223 can dispatch an animal the size of a deer or human in one shot. Can. Provided the right bullet is used in the rifle with a proper shot placement. It really gets to me the way the movies portray weapons. My wife hates watching movies with me that are shooter based. I can't help but pick them apart. Yeah, me too, man. Most of them are ridiculous fiction, like saying that a 223 shouldn't be used to take a deer, or a man on a ridgetop in windy conditions shooting a man in a moving vehicle at 1,000 yards, but he always gets the headshot. It's BS. Wouldn't happen. That's from a famous movie from a few years back in the opening, I think. Anyway, just my two cents. Keep up the good work, Mark. That is Marty from the Ozarks. Flat out. Thanks, man. And yeah, I don't want to delve too much more. I could talk for hours on ballistics. That was one of my hobbies when I was younger. But you're absolutely right. 308 is a fine cartridge. 223, again, it'll win wars. Sure, but I don't think it's doing the individual as much good. Anyway, sorry. This one's from Dave Tanner. Hi, Mark. Santa proves, this is the last time I'll probably do a holiday reference, Santa proves the azimuthal equidistant model. Write all those presents, central distribution hub at the North Pole. Dave T. And you're right, Dave, because Santa would be at the North Pole, which is the center of the map. That's awesome. Barbara writes, hello, Mark. Thank you for what you've been publishing about Flat Earth. I've spent the last 3 days, and today as we speak, watching videos on YouTube, and I am completely blown away. I have found people don't want to talk about this. One friend, who's female, is open-minded enough and is looking at some of the videos, sorry, your videos that I linked to her. I have a 31-year-old son who laughed at me. I told him we can't live in a ball or we'd fall off. He came back a bit later and went to the kitchen. He came out with a roll of tin foil and bopped me on the head with it. He said, continuing our previous talk, we don't fall off because of gravity. I told him gravity has never been proven. So he said atmosphere, pressure, and I asked him how the atmosphere stays with the Earth when the Earth is allegedly rotating at over 1,000 miles an hour, and then Earth is rotating the Sun at the same time at 66,000 miles an hour. So what's doing it? Velcro? I have piqued his attention. Your videos and other sources are supported by way too many people, and the subject is being investigated by way too many people, and I think it's because they are so complete and clear. Thank you again. Have a good day. Barb Van Zandt. P.S. Every man in my family, and I can pretty much verify back to the revolution, as I'm a direct descendant of Francis Marion, who is a Freemason, has been a Freemason. My father was the 33rd, a shrinker. I don't know what that is. Both of my grandfathers were, oh, Shriner. Spell check. This is not something I would sit here and blindly deny. The earth is not round, and my entire family has been on it for hundreds of years. Holy crap. Nice. Thank you, Barbara. This one's from Chuck, and he says, don't say my name online. All right, I will not say your last name. Energy Wave. Hi, Mark. I've been listening to your shows for quite a while now, and I'm convinced that the world is flat. This is not, however, why I'm writing you. Straight to the point, I was watching a video by Secure Team today about an energy wave that has just been detected. Immediately, I thought of a video I had seen about the path of eclipses not making sense on a globe. Someone had taken the time to lay out the coordinates of these on a Gleason's map, and they then appear as a circle. I thought that maybe you would know who had done this and how to get a hold of them. I don't, and no, not offhand. Don't worry though, you know, be persistent, you'll find it. I think it would be very interesting to see this energy wave laid out the same way. Maybe we should be able to locate its origin. Maybe CERN or even HARP is located at its center. If so, this may be the thing that is needed to help get a fix on the true shape of the Earth. If this energy wave is circular, then more than likely it would have to be perfectly so. And adjustments could be made to the Gleason's map to correct for discrepancies. What do you think? Yeah. Yeah, I think it's very possible. And somebody should do a little bit more research. I don't have the time, but that's a good one. Thank you. For looking into that. This one's from Kirk, and he says, North Carolina, it's flat, license tag photo. NC Spaceman just got it in the mail from the DMV today. Here you go, Mark. Thanks for your channel, Kirk. Kirk out. Beam me up, Scotty. And what he sent was the license plate. As you guys know, you're probably watching the slides go by. Hopefully I included it here, was that I had the first Flat Earth license plate. I just said it's flat. You know, you get 6 or 7 or 8 letters depending on what state you're in or Canadian province. And people have been coming up with creative stuff like Flat Earth and or F-L-A-T-E-R-H or E-T-H. And there's one guy that's doing one, I don't have a picture of it yet, called No Curve. That's 7 letters. It is flat. And the most common one is it's flat. I-T-S-F-L-A-T, because you get 7 letters most of the time. You can abbreviate that to I-T-S-F-L-T. So he did that in North Carolina. So anyone that does it, I will absolutely include it in a slide and probably make it as a thumbnail. And we got quite a collection so far going. I think we've got 15 states and not quite half of the Canadian provinces yet. But I'm really, really, it's really, really cool. And I love it. It's a subtle way to put it out there and represent and still be somewhat anonymous, because I don't necessarily have to read your name, and I don't put your name on top of the license plate when I show it. So great. Thank you. Thank you from North Carolina for doing that. Let's see here. Justine writes, Mark, if the earth is flat, as the saying is now being broadcast by people to seem to have too much IQ, flat earth would mean that once the sun is visible, all countries would experience sunshine at the very same time as the rays of the sun would hit the entire surface of your flat earth. A very old argument, but I'll get into it. This means every country would experience daytime at the same time. Answer me this if you have the guts. How do some countries experience night while some are experiencing day? And also, how can other countries be one day ahead and others on other flatter, blah, 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 blah. Thank you, Justine Johnson. And yeah, Justine, who's not quite on board yet, it's totally fine. What you're assuming here is that the sun is an omnidirectional light source, which we've all been taught since we've been kids. That's not the case anymore, though. It's not an omnidirectional light source. And so... it's a directional light source, more like a spotlight, shining down. There's some wonderful computer models and physical models that are out there. Look up the wonderful physical model by Chris Pontius. That'll give you a great idea. And that is on a flat Earth, the sun is orbiting over this flat plane like a mobile above a child's crib, but it's only emitting so much light and it's not omnidirectional. And if it is a limited light source, then yes, absolutely, you can have light and darkness and time zones and the whole nine yards. So, but thank you for asking the question. Gotten it before, and I didn't have to read it, but it's good to have refreshers out there. Let's see here. This one's from Sarah. It's called Clue 1 through 11. Hi, Mark. My name is Sarah. I just recently watched your video this afternoon. I have many friends that believe in the flat earth theory, and I'm on the fence. With that being said, I'm deeply religious, Christian, but I don't believe in organized religion. Like I stated, I've watched your video, and it's impressive. Job well done. I took your advice and decided to email you. I do have a question. So here it goes. You stated in your video clues to do with man-made volcanoes. Previous to that, you stated man has only dug or drilled as far down as 8 miles. I agree. You then proceeded to say man-made volcanoes or keep up a facade. You also stated that volcanoes can be as deep as 20 to 50 miles down. I think by now you see my issue. Kindly get back to me. I'm curious. Thank you, Sarah. I need some water. So here's the deal, Sarah. I didn't say that man created the volcano system. I'm saying whoever built this place, whoever the creators of this dome, this flat earth, this snow globe, this terrarium, this planetarium, whatever you want to call it, they were the ones that built everything from the jet stream, which is the upper atmosphere air current system, kind of like an air conditioner, to the underwater conveyor system, which is the water currents, kind of like a hot tub, that circulate the ocean water, to the magma system, were built by the creators, not us. Yes, man, you're absolutely right. What you pointed out there would have been a paradox if I had actually said that we were the ones that created everything. So the fact that mankind, our civilization, has only drilled down 8 miles or 12 kilometers. Is an indicator that, yes, since we can't even get to the magma system with drills, of course we didn't build them. No question. So hopefully that clears it up. No, the creators built the magma system. We did not. Moving on. This one's from Trash Lord. No name. No, I'm sorry. Hi, Mark. My name is... the email is called My Flat Brother. B-R-U-T-H-A. Hi, Mark. My name is Aaron O'Gwin. Nice. And I live down in the boot heel of Missouri. I've been on board since April of 2014. Pfft, wow, that's pretty impressive because I wasn't on board in April of 2014. And I love me some flat chat. And I really can't wait for the day I get to tell some people I told you so. All caps and 4 exclamation points. I was wanting to know if you had any information about how long it'll be till the big day, all caps, when the world is told the truth. I'm going to make a prediction in the next Hot Potato show, Patricia Steer. I'm actually going to say that it's going to be 2017. I'm going to say that it's been smoldering too long underneath the surface, and there's so many people that know at this point. I think there's millions of people that know. I've already seen single and second degrees of separation where I'm circling back people that don't know about Flat Earth. I'm hearing stories from them. People that don't know that I'm into Flat Earth, I'm catching some stories that are looping back to me. So I think it's already out there. The only reason we haven't talked about it, you know, it's that it's not common knowledge is because mainstream has not pulled the trigger. They have not hit the big red button on this, and I don't know why. So I do believe in the 100th monkey effect, though. And then once it hits a certain level of people, what that number is, I don't know, that it'll be common talk around water coolers, and then all of a sudden there'd be an investigation into NASA. So if you're the powers that be, you've got to stop that before it happens. You've got to stop the investigation. You've got to reveal this thing before it turns legal, before it turns ugly. So I'm going to say it's going to be in 2017. We're so close as it is. The trending, we're trending bigger than most mainstream topics of, and we've done it without any marketing dollars whatsoever. It's incredible the traction this thing has gotten. And imagine what you could do with a single celebrity or a single story or a single show, single reality show, and this thing would break wide open. It's already the most polarizing topic on the internet. I know this for an absolute fact. Look at the chat logs. Look at the forums. Everyone just, you cannot ignore it. You are either for it or you're against it. Nobody is just saying, oh, I can take it or leave it. That's crap. It creates so much passion. So I'm going to say it's going to be in 2017. I'm not going to be more specific than that because honestly, I mean, I couldn't have called in 2016 that Neil deGrasse Tyson and rapper B.O.B. would have gotten into a rap battle about it on mainstream television, which is weird because after that, it kind of dropped off. You know, no other celebrities have touched it yet. So I think it's going to be 2017. Anyway, moving on. Michelle writes, hi, Mark. Thanks for the fascinating video. I came across your video on YouTube about a week ago as I was interviewing Ron from Creation Lightship website. I caught him mention that the Earth is flat. I don't have an exact date, but I do the Wednesday night radio show on BBS Radio, and all shows are archived on Experience Instant Healings Now, online and active 24/7. Honestly, you can probably hear me go, okay, because I literally had no comeback for his comment. He was speaking about current battles on the physical plane and otherwise in Antarctica. Anyway, you may be interested to listen, as I will be bringing this up, and I will hopefully get talked about tonight, Friday, December 23rd. You may hear it live by going to the website I mentioned earlier or calling numbers. I believe you will be very interested. Thank you again for your video. I am forwarding it to Ron. Sincerely, Michelle. Thank you, Michelle, for that. Daniel writes, hi, Mark. You've got to listen to these two videos if you haven't heard them already. I know you are familiar with Crow 777. The guy he's interviewing is Robert Bassano. Robert is a heavy academic type, but comes across as a very humble and grounded with a lot of common sense. He did some pretty damn fine research to conclude that the Hubble telescope is a hoax and also discovered very interesting things along the way. The videos cast a wide net over a variety of topics, and near the end of the second video, Robert lends some evidence to suggest that space beyond the force field dome could actually be liquid helium. There is also a mind-bending discussion on stars, amazing new information which is ultimately related to Flat Earth. On a side note, let me know if I might be able to work for you on some level. You wouldn't have to pay me anything as long as I can be able to be exposed to a broader network of people, or I might eventually be able to earn some type of living for myself. As you might remember from some earlier correspondence, I've been blackballed from my former life as a pharmacist. Oof, sorry about that. I don't remember that email. I love to write, never tire of it, never afraid of scout work. Thank you, Daniel. And yeah, Daniel, you know, I don't know what the new opportunities will bring, but I'm always keeping people in mind. So Let's see, this one's from William Genske, Genske. And I think he's out of France. Professional voiceover clues in French. Hi, Mark. Here's a link to a playlist created by ITV, a French truth conspiracy research channel, for your series of clues professionally translated and voiced over into the French language. And yeah, it's on YouTube. It's on YouTube channel ITV. And I also put it on my channel. I compiled them all and called Flat Earth Clues French and then the French words for it. I'm not going to try to say French words. These vids are getting a tremendous amount of attention here in France, and it's starting some very good conversations. I am hopeful that by you posting this list amongst your resources, I will have additional reach to people otherwise unable to speak and understand English. Thank you for your ongoing efforts and work towards exposing this most wonderful reality. Kindly, William Genske. And yeah. If anyone wants to translate this thing, and I know someone, a lot of people have already done the text version. If you want to do the audio version, feel free, by all means. The videos are out there with all the audio on them, and you can, if you want to translate into Spanish or Chinese or Japanese or Arabic or whatever you want, I will absolutely put it on my channel, and I will mention it and create a whole separate video for you as well, and more than happy, to do it. So thank you. Anything to get the word out. That's awesome. Moving on. Anthony writes, Mark, I'm about 98% convinced the Earth is flat. I just have one question. If the moon rotates in circles above us, why do we only see one side of the moon no matter where you are in the world? You should ask mainstream science why that is. When it comes to the sky, I'm going to use the same line I always use, which is it's a planetarium. So you can display, because we can do this in software now, it's called instancing. You can create any image in the sky based on geographical location if you want, or heck, even by the individual if you really want to do it. So when everything is possible when it comes to the sky, if you want to spell out your names and name in stars, if you want to put your face on the moon, if you want to do you want to start making them twinkle like Christmas lights, you could. It's not difficult. It's the stuff on the ground which is the that's the tough part, in my opinion. But thank you for asking that. Excuse me. Morning time. Lou writes, Mark, I just watched your video, They Are Hiding God, with the greatest lie ever. I'm a believer in conspiracy theories, and for the past year, I have been watching a lot of different theories about our existence. I do believe in our creator or creators. I believe in energy also, and that we have a soul. What I'm really confused about, and I hope you can help me here, one of my friends who is a conspiracy believer asked me to watch some videos about these things, or creatures, reptilians, or other demons, and about Lucifer. I believe in our creator, but I'm puzzled about these other creatures and the devil. I know there is evil in the world. I guess what I'm trying to ask you is if you believe in demons or reptilians or such things in this world. If there are such things, I would like to know how to get rid of them. That's a tall order. Do I believe in demons and or Lucifer? Yes, I do. As a matter of fact, because you cannot have light without shadow, good without evil, constructive, I'm sorry, construction without destruction. Or how many different ways could we say that? You guys get the point. Which is yes, when it comes to at least Lucifer, absolutely. I believe you, because every storyline for every protagonist, you've got to have an antagonist, hero, villain. And when it comes to reptilians, I think that's a completely different group, which is I believe there are previous versions of this world, previous civilizations that have survived, at least remnants of them. If we are version, let's say version 7, who were the people of 654321? Who was the first group? And when you get into that, are we talking biblical stuff? Are we talking that the version 1.0 was the fallen, and was everybody else descendants or alterations of that group? I don't know. As far as getting rid of them, that doesn't happen until this world comes to a close. I believe that anyone that's flying around up there in spaceships and other higher technologies, that we're remnants of, who, you know, take your pick, Atlantis or some of the sunken cities off of Japan or India, whoever really built the pyramids. I think they're still around. At least some of them are. But I don't think they're allowed to interact directly with us. I think for whatever reason, the protocols are still in effect. Maybe that'll change this year, this upcoming year in 2017. But right now they are not allowed to land in Main Street anywhere. So I think you're relatively safe for the moment. Do some people get picked off in, you know, in the mountains or boats or forests? Yeah, every once in a while, sure. But I don't think that really breaks the rules. It's bending the rules, but it's not breaking the rules. So hopefully that answers your question a little bit. Sleep easy though, man. You're in a wonderful, intimate flat earth. Let's see. Mark Leader writes, "Mark, it's nice to meet you. I have something that came across my mind that I want to share with you, as it might be something or maybe not. I've been seeing this map come up online a few times from the Hawaiian Times or something like that, 1907, a map showing the flat Earth with many countries on the other side of Antarctica. It was supposedly from 1,000 years ago. I'm sure you've seen it, as it's been around for a while now. Anyway, an idea popped into my head, which seems plausible and answers why the scientific community in the know always knocked down the flat Earth proof." And before I read the rest of this email, yes, look up Chris Geo or Chris and Cherie Geo, 1,000-year-old map, flat Earth, where it's a wonderful publication from Hawaii from the early 1900s, which showed what I like it because it had the double wall. It shows a flat Earth map surrounded by two rings. One would be the coastline of Antarctica, and one would be the outer edge. And there seems to be thousands of miles between those two. And then outside of it are completely isolated continents all spread around this dome enclosed structure. Thought it was very, very interesting. So anyway, all the balloons and rockets that go up that show that there is no curvature of the Earth are true. And we also may be living on a globe, but not as you know it. If the globe was so huge that in the small area that a camera could focus, then it might seem that the Earth looked flat because it can't get out far enough to see the entirety of the whole diameter of the globe. This would explain why all the globe pictures from space are fake, stitched pieces of photos and computer-generated images. Perhaps that old map is not the entire globe map, but only just a known portion way back then, but there is still yet more undiscovered. This information, if indeed they went into low Earth orbit for the purpose of spying, would answer why everything seems to be faked. Of course, they couldn't let out this kind of information because it would be mind-blowing to find out that our so-called globe that we believe we live on is really like we are only a tiny island on a much larger planet. Too many questions would be asked as to what is out there, who is out there, why weren't we told? It would be too much for normal folk to come to terms that we might be actually like those natives that have had no contact with the outside world and can't be integrated into normal society. The true owners of this world may be the occupants of all these spaceships that we see flying around, and they might come from the other side of the Antarctic region. I'm not trying to prove the flat Earth theory wrong. I'm just saying that it might be more than you originally thought, Mark." And yeah, Mark, I've heard this. You literally since month one. But you got to remember where your idea is coming from. To say that, okay, it's not a globe as we know, it's just a much, much bigger globe, means that you haven't broken out of the whole solar system model yet. Who says, because at that point you're still believing in space. Who says there's space outside of here? Who's saying it's just not a giant flat plane with more and more and more things that extend on for a long, 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 long time? To keep, you know, I've heard this from a whole bunch of people starting since, you know, I introduced the Flat Earth Clues in February of last year, which is people keep saying, well, maybe it's just a much, much bigger planet. It's like, who told you there were planets to begin with? Why do you keep thinking there are planets? Because the scientific community, because NASA told you there were planets? Try to break out of that, even for a little bit. Keep it as flat as possible. Well, the saying is true, keep it flat. All right, moving on. But it's not a terrible idea. It's just one that I think is a little short-sighted. Dwight writes, "Hello." Wait, what was the screenshot from? He sends me a screenshot. Oh yeah, it's from Neil deGrasse Tyson. Neil deGrasse Tyson sent a posted something on Twitter. Hello, long-time listener, first time making contact. Anyhow, I came across this on my Facebook and thought it was worth sharing. It is a quote from your bestie, nice, which is Neil deGrasse Tyson, the man I do not want to break for if I ever see him in a crosswalk. Keep up the good work in getting the word out. And so this is a Facebook post from Neil Tyson, and he says, when the facts are what people want to be true in spite of contrary evidence, witness the beginning of the end of an informed democracy. And he posted that on December 10th. 2016 at about just about 8 o'clock at night. So thank you, Neil, for staying consistent and staying a jackass. Michael writes, greetings, Mr. Sargent. My name is Michael Slim from Phoenix, Arizona, and I am in need of your help finding a lawyer that believes in flat earth like myself. This is for a task God has ordained me to do. Oh boy. You were the first resource I thought of when God told me to move ahead on this. I just need a little bit of help locating the right individuals to get this moving. I intend to put the U.S. government on trial all over the lies and deceptions they put on us regarding the flat earth. In other words, I'm going to be suing the American government on behalf of every person on earth. Please return my call at your earliest convenience. This is not a joke. This is something that I feel in my heart I have to do. You can reach me at... And he puts his phone number there. Sincerely, Michael B. Slim. Hey, if anyone wants to get a hold of Michael, I'm just going to give out his email address so that way I don't have to play the middleman. His email address is Michael, MichaelSlimphx at gmail.com. So if anyone wants to help him with suing the American government on behalf of the Flat Earth, hey, wonderful. Thank you, Michael, though, for reaching out. This one is from... We got a little time left. I think we can get through most of these. It's from Eric Dwayne Wolf. First, let me say, wow, what a video. I watched the entire video just the other day. I've waited to email till today because I needed a few days to reflect. I can't lie. I hit the floor immediately with tears, asking God for forgiveness with a sincere heart. I am currently 38 and all my life I've listened to music. I've always felt subtle messages through music. You actually hear what the people are saying. Now with so much social media, even more people can have access to the truth. No more excuses, really. In 2016, we still have wars, poverty, hunger, suffering. I never did find God in church. The image they project is inaccurate. I've been homeless. I visited the sick and dying, gave to the poor half of what I had when they needed my help. I've been forgotten, rejected, neglected, abused, and disrespected, but love is powerful. I've been trying to find God my whole life. I've never given up. I've found him in the streets by the very people society has shunned as poor and unequal, economically defunct. They took care of me and fed me, gave me shelter, even money. God's love is the only thing, man. God cannot hide from people. One day the whole world will see God for what he is, if you will, and the rest of history, literally his story. I am a poet, an Aquarius, humanitarian by nature. If you don't mind, I have a rap song I've been trying to finish recording. I want to share it with you. It's not in the studio, but just listen to the words. It's a message from God to America. Her time is up. It is written. In the last days, the truth will be revealed. Continue your work. Sincerely, Eric Dwayne Wolf. Yeah, send me the lyrics. You guys can send me any song you want. I won't make videos out of every song, but if you have lyrics and it's a catchy tune, or even an obnoxious tune, I might put it up there. I've already got quite a few tracks of this year. We've got 50 tracks from last year, 2015, and about almost 100 for this year. That gives you an indication of how it's growing. And find me other conspiracies that have that many songs. So, this one's from Agent Black. 82. Hey Mark, Agent Black here with Men in Black Investigates. Here's a license plate. It's flat in a popular video game, GTA 5 for Xbox One. It's all flat. It's all fake. Don't get neuralized. And I saved this one and put it in a put it in part of the slideshow. So that's kind of fun. This one's called Global Technologies And hi, Mark. First, Merry Christmas. I'm about 80% of the way to be convinced regarding flat Earth, and this is blowing my mind because I've been the space kid all my life. One thing I haven't seen anyone commenting on is the shooting stars we see. What are they? Thanks for all you do. P.S. I sure understand the knee-jerk reaction of people. My best friend's husband, when I mentioned I was looking at this, analyzing it, just cut me off and said not to discuss it in his presence or just allow him to leave the room. He equates it to questioning his belief in God. Wow, I was just blown away. That's from Barbara. As far as the shooting stars, I do think they're part of the system. The meteors and shooting stars and comets, I do think they're part of the system. But you have to ask yourself, the meteors that enter the atmosphere, why don't they ever, ever, ever hit satellites, with the exception of the movie Gravity with Sandra Bullock and George Clooney? Why aren't they hitting satellites? Why aren't they sending satellites, firing them into pieces? Why are they not punching holes through the ISS? Why aren't the guys at the ISS constantly wearing spacesuits? Because they should be scared of any random meteor that we can't track, because we can't track everything that's flying through the sky. Meteors are a wonderful question. So, moving on. Texas Sky. This is from Cher? Can't tell. Mr. Sargent, I recently moved from Ohio to Texas, and the first thing I noticed is that Texas has a bigger, wider sky than Ohio. Why is this so? That's awesome. Well, it's obvious, isn't it? It's because everything in Texas is bigger. It's true. Everyone does it. No, the sky is this is it, no, the Texas does not have a bigger, wider sky. You're probably in a flatter part of Texas. There's a lot of really, really flat parts in Texas. Ohio, I don't think as much. So, this one's from Alan. Coming down to the end here. Good morning and Merry Christmas. I run the sound system at a church and have to move the slides for PowerPoint. I noticed that some slides had a curved earth background on them. It all happened so fast, like the spirit was moving through me. I changed two of the slides to a flat earth background. The first pic shows what the original slide background was. The second pic shows what I changed them to. After the service, he rushed back and asked to have the sound room so he could prepare the next PowerPoints. After he left, I checked the one we just did and it was changed back. I tried not to laugh. You have opened my eyes to a whole new plane of existence that is not an accident and full of wonder. I am planning on doing balloon experiments in the summer with a variety of cameras. Any input would be greatly appreciated. We must keep exploring. Thanks. The guy you want to actually talk to as far as balloon experiments would be Bob from Globebusters. So what I'm going to do, if I'm going to put up your email address here, and well, not put it up, I'm just going to read it. And hopefully Bob, if he's listening to this, or anyone wants to let Bob know that the guy's doing a balloon experiment and he wants some feedback. So it's Alan G is the guy that wants to do the balloon experiments, and his email address is nuts for planes. NUTSFORPLANES 1@gmail.com. So hopefully you and Bob get together. And in fact, maybe I'll keep this email and I'll put it in Bob's Skype box as well, just so he knows. This one's from Chuck. Chuck writes, Mark, I love your show. At the 3 minute and 30 second mark, he speaks of the Coriolis effect. I think he is wrong. I am still working in the shadows on the moon, respectively, Chuck. And he's talking about a YouTube video, and I gotta pull it up real quick. And the YouTube video is called Earth is a Sphere, Few Proofs for the Flat Earth Society. And it's from the YouTube channel. It's called LAURENTIU space A. So he's talking about the Coriolis effect. Yeah, he's absolutely wrong. I look at my subject matter experts from the Coriolis effect when I did any of my testimony shows. Look up the playlist I have on my YouTube channel called Testimony Shows, and everyone, and especially the military guys that deal with the Coriolis effect, they all say the same thing. So they go, yeah, we've all heard about it, we just don't use it in our daily lives. So I got 10 minutes. See, I can get rid of these last ones. Daniel writes, Nope, can't read that one yet. Oh, this one. John writes, hi Mark, this is John. Merry Christmas. I have a genuine interest in the flat earth theory. I am aware of the evidence, however it is limited, similar towards the idea of a sphere round earth. Given the strong presence of barriers that limit the proof of a sphere round earth, it only pushes more of the idea of alternate theories, mainly the flat earth. The historical evidence for the flat earth is vast, and you can reveal it similarly in your video presentation. I have some questions for you and would appreciate ideas that pertain any knowledge you have researched into the matter. I would also appreciate any references that I can look into that would help expand my knowledge to the theory, since my questions have so far remained unanswered due to the complexity and information that is hard to find. Please see below for questions. What sort of questions do you have? Let's see here. I'll rattle some of them off. Have you found any historical content that ties with who placed the barriers that surround the flat earth? No. Once Antarctica starts to melt enough to reveal large mass, do you think this will prove the flat earth theory? No, because I don't think it's going to be melting anytime soon. Do you think that Virgin Airlines will have permission to commercialize their orbit space flights in the short future? No. The Virgin Galactic and SpaceX are going to be severely handicapped all the way. And they can talk about going to Mars and doing all sorts of fun things all they want. They're just kicking the can down the road. They can't do anything because of the detection ability is way too refined now. If you believe in having a soul, do you believe ancient Egypt unknowingly had ideas that tie into the flat earth in relation to their theory with their Book of the Dead, since they mentioned the similarity towards needing to pass through barriers before they were able to spend eternal life in the afterworld? Yeah, I do. Do I think that your soul is judged and you have to weigh against a feather? I think it's a little more complex than that. I think that everyone eventually gets to some sort of afterlife after this. But I also think you have to reflect on what you've done here, and did you learn anything here? I do treat this more like yes, it's part education, part entertainment, but I think it's mostly a school than anything else. I think you learn perspective here, if not anything else. There are other broad ideas that pertain to death and barriers that must be faced before being able to move forward towards the afterlife. However, if unable to succeed through the barriers, one soul is sent back to earth in terms of reincarnation. I'm not sure if I buy reincarnation totally. This can be seen in the Christian belief Book of Revelations. Once dead is faced with temptation to become misled with the devil to hell, or seeking guidance from God to find a way to heaven. This idea is similarly towards Buddhist teaching as well as in terms of reincarnation. Is this idea of heaven and hell also analogies towards these indicated barriers that surround the flat earth and the space beyond the barrier? That is one of the longest questions ever, and I have no idea how to answer it. I think it's kind of a rehash of what you asked in the previous paragraph. I do think that we have to go through barriers to get out of here, but I don't think there's that much judgment involved. I mean, there could be judgment, yeah, but I think that it's also a question like a test, you know, like a blue book test, like a university exam. I think it's what you have learned and did you gain perspective from it. If you believe in other intelligent life forms other than human aliens in our galaxy, are they also encapsulated within the barrier, given the barrier can be infinitely reaching than one may think? Yes, I do. I do believe there's other civilizations here. I've said this many times. I think they're either trapped in here with us or they have access in and out through, and there could be both. You don't know. But I do think they're in here. Do I think they're from Mars and Venus and these giant worlds that are outside of here? No. Do I think they're from continents outside of here? Yes. Yes, I do. But I don't, you know, I do not believe in the solar system model and space. You don't have to have space if you can fake it. You can have anything outside of this. This could be God's footstool for all we know. Do you think that the flat earth only pertains to our dimension within our time and space, or does it affect other dimensions and other galaxies? Again, don't believe really in galaxies, other dimensions. Yes. Yeah, so do I think there's other dimensions laying on top of this one? Sure, why not? It's a frequency. We have frequencies for radio, we have frequencies for television, we have all sorts of frequencies. It's very, very possible that we are living in a multi-dimensional section, you know, not necessarily the Russian stacking doll argument, but I do believe that. Is the flat earth theory connected to the hollow earth theory? Yes, I do. Yes, it is. is one and the same, except one focuses on the top of the earth and the other below and within the construction of the earth. Yes, I do. That's how I got into this, was I was looking into the hollow earth theory, and then I realized the people that were researching hollow earth theory were eventually looking at the outer markers, the outer edge, the outer ring. And look up Admiral Byrd. It's a great example. Do I think there's civilizations living underneath us in a hollow earth scenario? Yeah, why not? Either they're either in other dimensions living right on top of us, or they're underneath, or both. Because remember, we live in a very, very narrow band. We live from 95% of our population lives from 0 to 5,000 feet. So you don't need much of a cavern. If your cavern was even 100 miles deep, or 100 miles wide, that's more than enough to have a full-blown civilization living down there. Is the hollow earth a ploy to discredit the flat earth theory, or conversely the other way? No, I don't think that either. I think they are completely symbiotic. You just got to get out of the whole idea that you need an entire hollow basketball to live in, when truth is you just need another layer like ours that's underneath. All right, do we have time for one more? I think we do. This one's from. No, I'll save that one. That one's too long. Let's see if I can get one more. This one's from Karsten. I'm diving in with this fringe theory of the flat earth stationary earth. I want to start by asking several pilot friends questions. I don't want to waste their time, so I was hoping you had 3 to 5 succinct questions so I could quote the answers when discussing. Karsten Smith. Wow, best questions to ask pilots. First off, before you even talk to them about anything, find out if they're into conspiracies at all. Do not bring up flat Earth unless they're open-minded enough. But if you want to ask some pilots some interesting questions, again, look at the testimony shows that I've done from the multiple pilots I've interviewed. The first one would be when you're looking up in an airplane, when you see a flat horizon. Do you have any, how do you know that it's not a perfectly flat horizon? How do you know it's curved? How do you know there's a curvature of the earth? Does your plane have to adjust for the curvature of the earth? And if it does it do it automatically or does it do it manually? Because every pilot has to go through manual flight training. Did they have to adjust for the curvature with their stick manually? That's one of the first questions you have to ask them. Because if the earth is flat and the gyro, is also flat, then yeah, when you get up to cruising altitude, it's going to stay flat. You never ever have to worry about it. But if it's curved, eventually you're going to keep gaining altitude unless the plane accounts for that. That's one of the first things you've got to ask them. And so yeah, ask them about the curvature, the 8 inches per mile, and how their gyro works, and how they account for the curvature. How do they adjust for it? That's all you really have to do to get them thinking. And then after that, if you want to be brave, depending on what kind of pilots they are, ask about the GPS system. Ask about why the GPS system has these dead spots, not only domestically, but over water. Why does a plane disappear off GPS from a civilian standpoint? Why can't you track the plane once it gets out 150 miles offshore? Why can't you do that? If it's a GPS system with 30 plus satellites circling the globe, there shouldn't be any dead spots whatsoever. And I've, had my best one was a flight instructor who owned his own flight instruction company out of Iowa that says that there's dead spots even domestically in GPS, even over the United States. That shouldn't even be possible, but there was. So that's why I would go with them. Do I have time for any more? I don't really. I'm sorry, guys. I'm about out of time here. Let's end on this last email. Sorry, real quick. Flat Earth, I need your help to convince more people the Earth is not is flat. This is in North Dakota. Everything we've been told is a lie. Please contact me back. Let's finally change the world. That's a good one to end on. So hope, I appreciate the enthusiasm. Anyone that wants to email me, please send me an email to msargent23 at comcast.net. If I think it's somewhat interesting, I will read it on Strange World and or the email shows, because unfortunately I get so many calls on Strange World now that I just can't even get through 10 emails. So I just crank them out in about an hour here. So anyway, thank you very much, guys. This would be the last, no, maybe one, no, this is the last show for the end of the year for 2016. Hopefully 2017 will be even a more significant year for flat Earth. It's been growing like crazy, and can't wait to see what happens in our flat Earth future. So check you later, guys.